Very good morning to all of you. We are going to discuss essay topics that have come in CAPF exam 2018. In this video, I am going to take up the first topic, civil wrong emerging from religious bigotry, constitutionally punishable. While analyzing all these six essay topics that have come this year, it seems that question setters set the essay topics in such a way that they always have four or more than four words. You can see the first topic has got 8 words. The second topic, 9 words. The third topic has got again 9 words. Fourth topic has got somewhat less number of words, 5 words. Fifth topic has got 7 words. And the sixth topic has got 5 words. Any essay topic has got 1 word or 2 words. It's very easy to write. However, when the essay topic is long, the writing becomes a little challenging. You know, while writing essay, you have to justify every word in your essay. And if you don't do so, you leave the major dimension of the essay or the major key components of the essay. Now, let's have a look at the first topic. Civil wrong emerging from religious bigotry, constitutionally punishable. Now, this is descriptive based topic. And in this topic, we have got 8 words. And among these 8 words, we have got total 3 keywords or 3 key components, civil wrong, religious bigotry, constitutionally punishable. So in your essay, you have to elaborate or you have to talk about all these 3 components, and then you have to establish the interrelationship between these 3 components. And actually, by establishing the connection, you'll be able to figure out the sequence of these 3 components in your essay. Now, what does sequence mean? You'll be able to know which key component will be located in which para. Will you talk about civil wrong in the first para? Or will you talk about religious bigotry in the first para? How about constitutionally punishable? Will you talk about it in your second last para or third para? Because see, the CAPF essay has got total 300 words and you have to divide these 300 words in maximum 6 paras, not more than that. So you have to decide the para-wise location of these 3 components. So first we are going to establish the connection. Religious bigotry leads to civil wrong. And when a person commits civil wrong, he is subjected to punishment under constitution. So our sequence will be first religious bigotry. And because of this religious bigotry, one commits civil wrong. And when one commits civil wrong, they are punishable under constitution. So this is the sequence. So in your essay, first you have to talk about religious bigotry, then you will proceed to civil wrong, and then you will talk about constitutionally punishable. If you analyze the interrelationship between the key components of the essay, and you will be able to find out the para-wise sequence of the key components, and if you write your essay sequence-wise, your essay would look organized, holistic, and interconnected line by line and para by para. So we have established the connection, we have found out the sequence. Now we are going to prepare the roadmap of the essay. At least 20 minutes you have to devote to one essay, and in this 20 minutes you have to devote at least 10 minutes to preparing the roadmap. Now see, I have prepared the roadmap. Now this is the roadmap. Actually, this is the draft which I have given another name, that is roadmap. First, I have to talk about religious bigotry. So what I have done, I have further fragmented this religious bigotry in 2 components. First, religion, and then comes religious bigotry. So in my essay, first I will give introduction on religion. I've already repeated many times in my videos that always start your essay with positive approach. So first I will talk about religion. Then I will proceed to religious bigotry, its meaning. Then I will deal with incidents related to religious bigotry, causes of religious bigotry, then its effects. Then I will come to 2 components, constitutionally punishable and civil wrong. And then I will draw conclusion and end the essay. Now this is the roadmap I have prepared. If you prepare the roadmap before writing final essay, definitely your final essay would look organized, holistic, interconnected. You won't deviate from the topic or the key components of the essay, and it will be very easy for you to restrict yourself to word limit, restrict yourself to para limit. Para limit in the sense, I have always told you to stick to 6 paras while writing 300 words essay. So you won't exceed word limit, you won't exceed para limit. And your time will also be not wasted in thinking what to write, what not to write, what to exclude, what not to exclude. You have already constructed the path. In your essay, just you have to walk down that path. I have not written this essay properly. Neither have I restricted myself to word limit. In this video, I'm just making you understand how to prepare the roadmap of the essay and how to follow roadmap in your final essay. See, first I have to talk about religion in general. I cannot talk about religious bigotry because religious bigotry has got negative connotation. So I cannot start with it. I have to start my essay with a positive approach. So I have fragmented religious bigotry in two components. First religion, then I will come to religious bigotry. So look at my introduction. India is a multi-religious nation where everybody has right to preach and practice his own religion, and this right is protected by our constitution. So I've talked about religion. However, religious bigotry, intolerance, fear and hatred towards the ones who are different from us have become too common in our nation. So in this line, I'm talking about the meaning of religious bigotry. That is, hatred towards the one who are different from us. So I have walked down on these two paths, right? Now I proceed to incidents related to religious bigotry. Now I have changed the pattern. In 2015, Pew Research Center analysis of 198 countries ranked India as fourth worst in the world for religious intolerance or bigotry. You can write bigotry as well. It will be more proper. Now, incidents related to religious bigotry. I've given these incidents. You can leave out one or two incidents, but you have to mention this one. Because if you mention this one, you are able to connect your essay topic with the current event. Then in the third para, I'll talk about the causes. What are the causes of these incidents? One is religious bigotry. Another one is inadequate knowledge of scriptures. Bigots mistake themselves to be the protector of God. Social media. Take advantage of religious sentiments of the public. I've just given points. I've not written this essay properly. Then in third para, you have to write the effects of these incidents that happen due to religious bigotry. Significant damage to property and far greater displacement of population. Growing destruction of egalitarian and human principles of secular democracy. Growing fear, insecurity and hatred among target community and making them feel second class citizens. Then in the fourth para, I'll talk about punishment under constitution, and it's a civil wrong. Religious bigotry is a civil wrong. Okay, so I've written religious bigotry is not a virtue and considered to be civil wrong because it snatches others' right as human beings through discrimination and persecution. Now this line gains weightage because of the incidents I have already mentioned that happen due to religious bigotry and its effect. Damage to property, destruction of egalitarian human principles, insecurity and hatred. The constitution and other laws and policies protect religious freedom, and in practice, the government generally respects religious freedom. However, some state level laws and policies restrict this freedom. Some state government has enforced existing anti-conversion laws, and some local police and enforcement agencies in certain instances were not swift to counter communal attack against religious minority. The Indian Penal Code lays down the provision for offense relating to religion. You can elaborate this line about the Indian Penal Code. I haven't given. In the fifth para, I have drawn conclusion. All religions teach love thy neighbor and that it is wrong to harm others. So any violence, murder or brutality in the name of religion is actually against the religion. And such bigots deserve punishment under constitution. So in my conclusion, I've mentioned the word religious bigots, punishment, constitution. So this is how students you have to write your essay. I have given you the skeletal framework of writing the essay. UPSC, you know, never gives the essay in one or two words. They do not give essay in a direct manner. They include so many words in the essay topic, and if the candidates do not elaborate the key words in their essay, then definitely they haven't justified their essay. And this is what examiner analyzed.